Welcome back to Informed Sources. In addition to the congressional primaries, voters in Shelby County also had to choose candidates for the state House and also the Senate. There was only one contested Senate race, which was District 30. Longtime state Senator Sarah Kyle defeated her Democratic challenger, Erica Stotts Pearson, getting nearly 70% of the vote. The senator will now face independent candidate Mitchell Morrison in November. So District 30, we're talking about downtown, we're talking about North Memphis, parts of East Memphis as well. Sarah Kyle has been there for 10 years. Is it just the power of the incumbency that's hard to beat there?
Well, Sarah has been very effective. She's very community-oriented, very, very connected to people, grassroots people. So I think maybe the incumbency is good, but she's been a good representative.
No Republican running in that district. Did the GOP just give up on that district?
Well, again, I just think you, this is just me speaking for the Republican Party. I think you have to choose those races that you can win, and does it really make sense to put a candidate in just to lose, quite frankly? Yeah, I mean, we've got to save our resources.
All right, now moving over to the Tennessee House, longtime state representative Joe Towns easily won his primary in District 84, beating Vernell Williams with more than 80% of the vote. Towns will be reelected in November since there are no Republican, again, or independent candidates running against him. We've seen this movie before. He's been there about 30 years. I guess he's there until he wants to quit.
Well, I guess if I were him, I'd be very excited about not having to spend money and running, but it's sort of sad that, you know, we elect people to these positions and it's like a lifetime appointment. I don't think that's good.
And he frequently runs unopposed. Does he keep that seat as long as he wants it?
You know, until someone raises their hand to give him a race, I mean, again, there's a lot of voter apathy that we hadn't talked about. There's very poor voter turnout, and so it's easy to get lackadaisical in those seats if you don't have an opponent. And I'm not saying Representative Towns is like that. I've known Representative Towns for a long time. But again, we're not challenging these candidates. And if you don't challenge individuals, they don't get better. And they're not on top of their game, quite frankly.
Well, one of the things that always motivates me, Greg, is that I'm looking at the districts that our elected officials represent, and the black community in Memphis has been a ghetto for decades, man. So somebody's not doing something.
Yeah. All right, let's go to District 86. Justin J. Pearson won the Democratic primary, beating David Page with more than 90% of the vote there. Pearson will face independent candidate Jeff Johnston in November. You know, Representative Pearson is passionate. He's also controversial. Does that make him more popular with the people?
I think so, especially among the people who tend to be politically active. And I think that were it not for the mistreatment that he received at the hand, and I think it's personality stuff mostly, I think that really boosted him, not just locally, but on a national scale.
Representative Pearson was one of the Tennessee Three.
Sure.
Does that help him in District 86?
Oh, I think it absolutely does. I think the Tennessee Three are known now nationally, if not internationally. And so I think you've got to be very respectful of that and pay attention to that. Because, again, I've seen Justin Pearson on CNN. I've seen him on Fox. And so he's getting a lot more attention than just here in the Shelby County.
Do you think you'll see him somewhere else besides the state legislature?
I don't think there's any question about it. I think it's a matter of what he wants to do.
All right. In District 93, longtime state representative G.A. Hardaway easily won his primary, defeating LaShonta Rudd, getting 75% of the vote. Hardaway will face Republican Renardo Clariette in November. So this is the district that cuts through pretty much the heart of Memphis there. Like Joe Towns, we've seen this one before, G.A. Hardaway going back to the state legislature if he can win that race in November. Is that a foregone conclusion, do you think, based upon what we've seen in the past in the state legislature?
If there's anything that exists that's a foregone conclusion, that's one of them. Yeah, exactly. I grew up with G.A. Personal anecdote. I had a puppy. G.A. lived across the street from us. My puppy got run over, run across Parkway, and G.A. was the one that came to our house knocking on, Blackie's dead, Blackie's dead. So that's why I support him all the time.
And what do you think about this district, again, running through the heart of Memphis?
It's going to be tough to defeat G.A. Hardaway. He's working. Right now he's got a lot of conversations going on about monitoring individuals with ankle monitors, except with accurate GPS at a real time. He's always working, and he's always on the TV, on the radio, and he's very present to his constituents.
All right, let's move on now to District 96. Gabby Salinas beat four other Democrats to replace the retiring Dwayne Thompson. Salinas got 44% of the vote, with Talisa Franklin coming in a close second with 41%. Salinas is unopposed in November, which will mean she will be serving. This was a close nip-and-tuck race right to the very end. Gabby Salinas is a former chairman of the Democratic Party. I guess that couldn't have hurt.
No, it didn't hurt her, and 32 votes, man, that was the difference. I was personally pulling for Talisa because of her community activism over the years, but that's a close race, man. Congratulations to Ms. Salinas.
You know, now, I think that Republicans held this seat about 10 years ago. What's happened since then?
Well, again, just to tip the hat to both these very strong women, they both worked really, really hard. As Pastor said, Talisa Franklin has been very strong in the community, is really responsible for all the Juneteenth activities. But what a story about Gabby Salinas. She came here as an immigrant. She fought cancer at ALSAC St. Jude, mm-hmm. and she is now an expert in health care. I think she'll do a lot of good things on the Hill.
Yeah. And again, representing parts of Memphis and Cordova.
Yeah.
Real quickly, let's go to District 97, where Representative John Gillespie won the Republican primary, getting 95% of that vote. Gillespie will now face Democrat Jesse Husseth in November. Now, this one is, I guess, East Memphis portions of Cordova as well. He's a three-term congressman. It's pretty tough. This seems like more of a, or not a congressman, legislator. This seems like a Republican stronghold for him.
Yeah, I'm bullish on this race. John Gillespie is doing a very, very good job. He's been a very outspoken person on public safety. John can raise money, and I think he's going to be very, very hard to defeat. And again, he's a young political leader that is growing in his seat and doing better and better. And again, I have a lot of respect for John Gillespie.
Unlike some of the other legislative districts in our area, this one leans more Republican. Do Democrats have a shot at this, do you think?
Well, I don't know if he want to take a shot right now, because John, as I was about to say, has been willing to work across the mm-hmm. aisles in ways that affect urban areas more than others. So, I wouldn't try to run against him right
now. All right. When we come back, we're going to turn our attention from the Tennessee primary to the Shelby County general election. We'll talk about the winners for General Sessions Court Clerk and the Memphis Shelby County School Board next on Informed Solutions.